guys, it's Mary Godwin, MD's Jimbo Channel. Don't forget, follow along on YouTube. Subscribe, like, and share. Hit the boop alert button so you know what's going on all week long. Follow us on Instagram, and please like and follow us on Facebook. You're going to get all sorts of cool content and bonus videos. Cheers, guys. Cheers, guys.
Everybody, and welcome to our virtual happy hour here at MD's Jingle Channel on this gorgeous, amazing, gorgeous Monday happy hour in South Florida. I have not seen weather like this. It's so beautiful. Oh my God, do you not love it? Anyways, let me know where you guys are. Are you freezing? Are you warm? Where you are, what you're drinking. I'm drinking beer because it just seems appropriate on this, like, beachy, boaty, lay in the sun, fun type of day, you guys. It's amazing. I just can't get over it. Also, it is National Strawberry Day. Yay! Who doesn't love strawberries? You guys, strawberries are so freaking good. And you know, I don't know if this is true, but I was told a long time ago, if you rub them on your teeth will get whiter. So I've been doing it forever. I've been doing seeds stuck in my teeth forever. Hey Denise, thanks for joining us. How are you? So, speaking of strawberries and seeds, did you know that strawberry is not really even a berry? It belongs to the accessory fruit category because the seeds are on the outside of the berry, not on the inside. So, there, you learned something new today. Thank you so much, Denise. So, strawberries. These were discovered in France back in the 14th century, but since then made super popular here since the 1930s, right here in Florida, Plant City, Florida, originally called the Florida Strawberry Fest, was the first place that made everybody wonder about strawberries and use them in everything you can think of. And that's starting now. So if you're near Plant City, Florida, check out the Strawberry Fest. It is going on. It's basically the first taste of spring, if you will. So I've come up with two cool drinks I'm going to make for you guys, the strawberries, in just a second. So let's put these things down. They smell so, so good. They're amazing. So like I said, you guys, let me know when you're watching. Say hi. Where are you from? What you drinking? What is going on? What you do today? It's Monday. Anyways, okay. It's almost St. Patrick's Day. My God. It's like 3 weeks from St. Patrick's Day. So I hope you're ordering your cute little green beer and all that stuff that you need off Amazon. Because Mr. Colin McGregor, ooh, hi Kevin. How are you? Mr. Colin McGregor, you know, the hot wrestler, MMA, whatever. I'm not sure what he is, wrestler, MMA, boxer. He's got, you know, he's got Irish whiskey out. So check this out. Seen here first, Colin McGregor's Proper 12 Irish Whiskey Apple Flavor. Yum, yum, yum. Apple, you guys. So this tastes like warm caramel apples with oak and brown warm sugar all in a shot. And this is really cool. Kevin, you're going to like this. They give, for every case sold, $5 to first responders worldwide. So, yay for Hot Colin. Thank you so much for doing that. That is great. Okay, now to the good stuff for me, wine. You know, everyone knows I love my red wine, and I love Josh. I love Josh so much, if I had a kid, I'd name him Josh. Yes, I know. Isn't that fantastic, you guys? Like I just said, $5 to every case of Proper 12 Apple sold. They're giving $5 to first responders worldwide. So get out there and purchase your Proper 12 Apple. So back to wine. Josh, this is brand new Josh Perth Cabernet Sauvignon. Let me see that picture, boys. Meow. Okay, so this was made during the pandemic when everybody was staying home and feeling all homely and all that. And just, you know, sitting around the fireplace and stuff. They came up with this and it just came out. I just got this bottle last week. You cannot get it in the store yet. Very, very soon. Josh Perth. Okay? This is bolder. It is richer. It is, in my opinion, it's a little bit thicker. You see? Because like, I drank it all. Can't even show you. Because I drank it all. I couldn't help it. It seems a little thicker, a little more velvety, kind of like really just perfect around, sitting around the fireplace, you know what I mean? So, this is got black cherries, it's got blackberries, smooth in volume, and get this, it's higher in alcohol content than your regular Josh Cabernet, because this is 14.5%. So, you know, like, when you see the girls walking around with their little, you know, like, guess what? They're smarter than the rest of you guys because they have more booze in their drinks, if that's what you're going for. I'm just saying. But Josh Kirk, Cabernet Sauvignon, totally like it a lot. So go shopping for it now. It's out probably now, next few days, whatever. Check it out. It's delicious. So. Okay. I just don't know. Carolyn's peanut butter. Look at this, you guys. Another peanut butter. I feel like, so this is Carolyn's. If you don't know Carolyn's Irish whiskey, it's kind of just like one step lower Bailey's. It doesn't cost as much. It tastes just as good. So if you need to make, you know, Bailey's on the rocks, go for the Carolyn's. You're not going to break the bank buying it. Well, they just came out with peanut butter. And I feel like everybody's coming out with peanut butter stuff, but must be a call for it. People like peanut butter. This one's 34 proof, so you're definitely not going to get like you are with this boy over here. So check out your Carolyn's peanut butter as well. If you want to spend a lot of money, and everyone's in love with tequila these days, look at this gorgeous, gorgeous bottle. Don Julio Rosado. That's right, Rosado. Okay, look at that bad boy. $133 for that bottle. And it's a 750. And I've got here the regular, Don Julio. This one was, I think, about $100. I'm not sure. A little bit left in here. Ooh, I'm told it was a little bit more. Okay, well, this one, the Rosado. Rosado means pink hue. So what they done is they took the Blanco tequila and they aged it in Pinot Noir casks and barrels. So it's got to be aged 2 to 12 months inside a barrel. And that makes it have a pink hue. And I'm not sure why it's $133, but it is. So it must be that good. We'll find out. If anybody wants to send me a sample, I'll definitely review it for you guys. That's right. Okay, let's get into the good stuff. National Strawberry Day. I came up with two drinks. So the first one, this one, and you're going to go nuts. If any of my girls watching, you're going to go nuts. Okay, so we took our Beach Blast, which is our Cape Fear Distillery Beach Blast. We talked about it last week, and it's so good. And I just can't get it out of my head, so I had to try this. And guess what I did? I took some strawberries, and I muddled them. Bottles of strawberries. Okay. So, real simple. You guys, so easy. My mom can do it. Hi, Mom, if you're watching back in Rochester, New York. She just left beautiful South Florida to go back to the cold tundra of Rochester, New York. So, if you're watching, Mom, you would love to have this. So, put some muddled strawberries in your shaker tin with some ice. We got them at my house so I can use my fingers. Take your Beach Blast Caribbean coconut rum. I put in about 2.5 ounces, okay? Again, it's at your house, so it doesn't matter if your measurements are correct or not. When you're shaking, someone just asked me this the other day, where does the glass go? The glass goes on top, away, always away, because if you're at work, you're at customers, or you have guests at your home, you don't want this flying up and hitting them. So, it goes backwards. All right, shake it up. You know you need those muscles to look good in your bikini. It's almost that season, everyone. So, get your arms worked out for bikini season. All right. Oh my God. Oh God, I'm gonna die. Ready? What I'm gonna do is strain that. Put these strawberries right in there. Ooh, little ice. That's okay. Nice and thick. Okay, check this out. Take a strawberry, tap this bad boy like that. Oh my God. Look at that. Are you gonna die or what? Oh my God. It's almost like a nice milkshake. It tastes like, oh my God, it almost reminds me of the bunny. The Nestle Quick Bunny, but better. And it's got Caribbean rum. All right. So I'm calling this the Strawberry Blast. It is delicious, delicious, delicious. Make that at home. Now, if you want to be a little more refreshing, because that's definitely sweet and delicious after dinner drink. So this one, make this right in the glass. This one's going to be your poolside drink. You might want this by the pool this weekend because they're telling me it's 87 degrees this Saturday here in South Florida. That's unbelievable. Okay, this one is called the Cherry Strawberry Lemonade. Just like it says, I took some Smirnoff cherry vodka. I would have used Tito's because, you know, the unofficial sponsor of MD's Gin Mill Channel is Tito's, but they don't make flavors. That's okay. So, cherry Smirnoff, just do. I always like 2 ounces here at the house. Not driving, and it doesn't matter. And then fresh lemonade. Okay. We're going to put a little bit of our muddled strawberry in here. This, oh my God, smells so fresh. Okay. Take your straw, stick it in. Real nice. You want to bruise your ice. Do not bruise the ice. And another strawberry. And look at that. Hi, Amanda. Look at that. That is a cherry strawberry lemonade with fresh muddled strawberries. No puree, no sugar, none of that. And I did use, oh my God. I used Crystal Light lemonade, so no calories in that either. Delicious. So those are my two favorite drinks here for National, oh my God, that's good. National Strawberry Day. And I wanted to touch base. Okay. So, you know, this is a virtual happy hour. And when you go out for happy hour, you talk about tons of different stuff. You talk about the weather, you talk about a boyfriend, a girlfriend, you talk about anything. And I wanted to bring this to your attention. Those of you who know me well know I'm always talking about Suzy Orman. I mean, I've been following her since, God, she was on Oprah Winfrey. Then she had that show where you could write in and ask, can I afford this? Can I afford that? So today I was taking a walk and I was listening to her podcast and she just announced today, yes, I have a picture of Suzy. So if you guys don't know who she is, this is what she looks like. She's fabulous. The name of her podcast is Women and Money Podcast. And she also says, for the men smart enough to listen. But it's a great podcast. It's free to download on your Apple or your Google Play. So today she was talking, well, it was yesterday because it's Sunday. She's on twice a week, talking about the interest rates going up and what you're getting for certificates of deposit. I like to share with all you guys, you want to make money, and who doesn't want to make money? I'm talking 3-month CD at 4.6% and a 6-month at 5%. You can't go wrong. So you need to learn about it. Go on her app. You guys, Suzy Orman, she's got great books out, everything. Go on her app, Women and Money app, and check it out. I'm telling you, who can't afford to put a couple bucks in there for 3 months and make money? It's a no-brainer. So I just had to throw that in there because it's just been all over my head all day today. Ooh, Mr. Kevin says, alcohol question when you have a second. Yes, sir, I am ready. Let's see that question. Let's see a question from Mr. Kevin. Yeah, we were looking at earlier, I was reading an article about Truly Seltzers. Do you guys, are you still buying them? Ah. Okay, Kevin, can you briefly explain the difference between ABV versus proof? Absolutely. ABV, alcohol beverage volume. So, for instance, let me find something here for you. Okay, so I've got this Smirnoff bottle, okay? I don't have my glasses on, so I can't tell what the ABV is. But the proof to this is 80 proof. And basically, 80 proof means it's probably, well, it's just half. So that's 40 ABV, 40 alcohol beverage value, 40%. So if you see something that says that it's 10% ABV, that means it's 20 proof. So you just double it. So I hope that answers your question. Really easy. So ABV, double it is your proof. So like wine being 14.5 proof would be half, 14.5 is the ABV. Kind of crazy, huh? I tell you. I don't know why they just don't make it the other way. But like I said, Truly Seltzers, they're rebranded. They are rebranded. Oh, you're so welcome, Kevin. Truly is rebranding themselves. They're going to be all over the place with natural fruit flavors now, okay? They're making citrus, they're making poolside pack. But you haven't really seen them too much. Do you guys still buy Truly, or are you just buying the claws? Are you buying the neutrals? Because you just really haven't seen too much of Truly. And they're rebranding to keep up with the pack. Because the whole seltzer thing is a little bit gone. That's okay by me. But we've got to keep smelling this. Ooh. So every Monday, I swear, I lose my appetite for dinner, for the taste of all this other stuff. It's so good. But you guys, I hope I helped you out a little bit today. There's just so much cool stuff going on. And stick around. I'm going to be doing some more videos all week. And thank you for joining us. And thank you to our sponsors here at MD's Dunal Channel. Of course, Exchange in America. You guys will be traveling a lot coming up. I know you are. InKind Graphics, KG Pro Renovations, Booz Bandage, the Jim Mill in Fort Pierce, Florida, and of course, Bogies and Stogies, Fort St. Lucie, Florida. Thank you, everyone. Have a great Monday, and cheers.